U.S. women's soccer team will face Marion right here at Bishop Darcy Stadium on Saturday, October 21st. The match begins at 7 p.m. and tickets are available online only by visiting stfranciscougars.com. USF men's soccer team will be home tonight against Goshen College at 7 p.m. Come back and finish the homecoming festivities with a Cougar soccer match.
I can hear you, yeah.
Steps up to the line. Puts the ball in the middle. Touchdown. It is homecoming 2023 on a cold and misty day at Bishop Darcy Stadium in Fort Wayne. Good afternoon. I'm Scott Truxell filling in for Joe Parson. Coming up, it is homecoming action between the St. Francis Cougars and Lawrence Tech. It is Cougar football on WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Welcome to our broadcast on this Saturday afternoon. Coming in, Lawrence Tech 1-5 overall. Meanwhile, the St. Francis Cougars 3-2 on the season. We'll set the stage, we'll take a look at both teams and more, and we'll do that after this timeout on News Radio WGL 1250 AM and 105.5 FM.
Gentlemen, at this time, would you please remove your hats for today's pregame prayer delivered by USF Peer Minister Junior Joanna Evanich. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the national anthem presented to you today by USF Director of Alumni Relations, Mr. Tony Dager.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air.
good afternoon and welcome back to Bishop Darby Stadium on this Saturday afternoon. It is misty, it is rainy, and we just had the presentation of the national anthem. Looks like the microphone might have shorted out due to the wet conditions. The visitors here this afternoon, the Lawrence Tech Blue Devils from Southfield, Michigan, 1-5 overall, 0-3 in the Mid-East League, led by head coach Avante Mitchell in his third season. They're coming off a loss to number 10 Concordia last Saturday. 24-10, the Blue Devils have lost to four straight. They led 7-0 after one quarter, but trailed 10-7 at halftime. Concordia pulled away with two third-quarter touchdowns to seal that victory. The Blue Devils have played three top 10 teams so far. Number 5, Indiana Wesleyan. Also, Marion in the top 5. Marion at number 4 this week and number 10 Concordia, so that 1-4 record may be a bit deceiving. Scoring has been an issue for the Blue Devils so far this season, averaging 13.5 points per contest. They averaged 313 total yards per game, 199 through the air, and 114 on the ground. Alex Osman is the quarterback. He's a 5'11", 205-pound redshirt freshman. He's completed 75 of 137 passes. That's just under 55%. He's thrown 6 touchdown passes and 10 interceptions. His favorite receivers so far, Jaden Wallace, 24 receptions, 333 yards and a touchdown. Jaden Rembert, 21 carries, 255 yards and 4 touchdowns. The leading rusher, that's C.J. Davidson, 5'11", 180-pound redshirt senior, 73 carries, 437 yards, and a touchdown. Defense also proving to be problematic this season for the Blue Devils. They give up just under 32 points per contest. They allow 412 yards per ball game. That includes 171 on the ground and 241 yards through the air. We'll take a quick break. We'll check out the USF Cougars, and we'll kick it off, and we'll do that after this. It's Cougar football on WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Welcome back to Bishop Darby Stadium, Darcy Stadium, I should say, on this Saturday afternoon. Scott Truxell with you, filling in for Joe Parson. St. Francis comes in 3-2 on the season, 2-0 in the Mid-East League. They climbed over 500 with a 42-28 win over Siena Heights last Saturday, 7-7 after one quarter, 14-all at halftime, 28-all after three quarters, but the Cougars scored twice in the fourth quarter to get the win. Grant Grimmel, 16 of 34, 293 yards, and three touchdown passes. So far this season, 52 of 99, 799 yards, six touchdowns, and three interceptions, as he's become somewhat of a long ball specialist for the Cougars. McCall Ray last week, three receptions, 113 yards, including an 80-yard touchdown catch. So after an 0-2 start, the Cougars have won three straight. And entering game number six, the Cougars are averaging 27 points per ball game, plus 361 yards per contest. That includes 140 on the ground and 221 through the air. Defensively, St. Francis is allowing just under 22 points per game, 354 yards per outing. That includes 138 on the ground and 216 through the air. Today's football game, the second of three events at Bishop Darcy Stadium. Earlier, the alumni men's soccer game was played at 7 o'clock tonight. It's men's Cougars soccer versus Goshen College. And the weather, well, it is a typical fall day in the Midwest. It is cloudy, it is wet, it is misting slash raining. We have a current temperature of 54 degrees. The weather forecast calling for an 80% chance of showers this afternoon. Plus, this could be a factor. North winds 10 to 15 miles per hour with gusts up to 30 miles per hour and a high temperature of 54, and that's where we're at right now as the two teams are out on the field for the coin toss. Last night on WGL, Snyder wrapped up an 8-1 regular season with a 35-0 win over Wayne, so the Generals finished 5-4. Playoff action coming up next, including Carrollwood Warsaw. That'll be October 27th at Warsaw. You can catch that game on WGL and on Z93.9. So plenty of ways to catch that game two Fridays ahead on the 27th of October. As we take a look at the two teams out on the field, a coin toss is here, and we'll be getting things underway shortly. Lots of umbrellas out, lots of rain gear here at Bishop Darcy Stadium as homecoming 2023 weekend events are in full force. As we wait for the coin toss, the results, and we'll see what both teams opt to do here to start the ball game. Again, it is a, we'll call it a heavy mist this afternoon. Showers, though, into the forecast. We're still out with the two teams at the midfield line. Grant Grimmel, just under 800 yards passing so far this season. Six touchdown passes, three interceptions. Three of those touchdown passes coming over Siena Heights last week. Cougars will hit the road next week. They'll travel to Indianapolis to take on Marion. The coin toss is complete. This seems to be the longest process today. Lawrence Beck, it appears, has won the toss and has elected to receive the football. So he'll go on offense first. Quarterback Alex Austin, 75 of 137 yards, or rather attempts, 913 yards, 6 touchdowns, and 10 interceptions. Favorite receivers so far, Jalen Wallace, 24 catches, 333 yards and a touchdown. Jaden Lambert, 21 catches, 255 yards and four scores. Nick Robinette, 12 catches, 121 yards. And Mauricio Jenkins, the tight end, 8 receptions, 116 yards. And Lawrence Tech coming in 1-5 on the season, 0-3 in the Mid-East League. Head coach is Avante Mitchell in his third season. Offensively, just under two touchdowns per ball game for the Blue Devils, 13.5 points. Defensively, giving up just under 32 points at 31.8 points per ball game. For the Cougars defensively, some names to listen for this afternoon. Hunter Byanski, a redshirt freshman on a Cherubusco, providing plenty of quarterback pressures the last couple of games. Connor Bryce, he's had a couple of sacks, 6'1" at 252-pound senior. And Corey Norris, a 6'1", 228-pound redshirt freshman. Linebackers, they're active. Nate Tellum, 6'4", 222 pounds from Franklin High School in Indianapolis. In the secondary, some names to listen for. Bailey Parker, 6'3", 200 and a senior. And Nate Newcomer, 5'11", 187. He's a redshirt sophomore. It looks like we are set to go. Tyler Garrett, freshman, 5'7", 160. Is one of the deep backs for Lawrence Tech. Coming back at about his own 5-yard line, Aiden Hosler getting it teed up for the St. Francis Cougars as we get set for homecoming 2023. Also back. Looks like Lawrence Drummond for the Blue Devils. And the officials are set. Two teams are set. There is the whistle. The approach, and this afternoon's game is underway. End over end kick will hit the deck at about the 12-yard line. Picked up on the one hop to the 20-25-yard line. And a return across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Tyler Garrett able to pick up some nice yardage on the return. And Lawrence Tech will start off first down and 10. Across the 30 at the 32-yard line. Again, Alex Osman, the quarterback, redshirt freshman, 5'11", 205. Starting running back is C.J. Davidson, redshirt senior, 5'11", and 180. Shotgun formation, twin receivers to the left side of the formation. Four down linemen for St. Francis. Snap comes back. They give to Davidson to the right side, and he is going nowhere. In fact, he has hit a brick wall and is going to be stopped for a 1-yard loss.
Tackle by number 48, Nate Tellum, Cougars.
Nate Tellum, one of the linebackers over there on the stop. Again, very active for this Cougar defense. It's a loss of one, second down and 11. Game just underway. Dual running backs in the shotgun backfield. Twin receivers to the left side of the formation, a single receiver to the right. Osman with a clap of the hands, calls for the football, hands it off. This is Davidson again, and again, he's going nowhere. He will get back to the original line of scrimmage, and that is it. Connor Price, one of the first on the scene to stop that play. It'll bring up third down and long for Lawrence Tech.
Cut by 23, Nate Newcomer.
A newcomer coming up from the safety position to make the stop. And the Blue Devils are right back at the line of scrimmage. Third down and long. Almost 10 yards. Osman back in the shotgun. Twin receivers to his right. Snap comes back. Osman back. Double pumps and down he goes. Connor Price, one of those there. Also back there was Emmanuel Davis, one of the linebackers. So three and out for the Blue Devils, and they will have to kick it away. The punter is Carter Dixon, 32 punts this season, 37 and a half yard average, and he's standing back at his own 10-yard line. Cougars should get relatively good field position out of this. David Smith, one of those back, as the kick is away, and it is an excellent punt. And it is hauled in at the 34-yard line. Coming near side to the right is David Smith. He will take it across the 40 to the 42, maybe 43-yard line. That's where the Cougars will start off first down and 10. Change of possession, 12:46 to go in the opening quarter. No score. This is the first possession of the game offensively for the St. Francis Cougars. 3-2 on the season, 27 points per contest. Grant Gremmel, just under 800 yards passing so far. And Peterson will line up to his left in the backfield. Twin receivers left, one to the right. Remmel puts the receiver in motion, and we have whistles and penalty flags as A.J. Dandritz went in motion. Officials will talk it over. I am guessing somebody flinched up front.
Butler, offense, number 34, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
So it'll make it first down and 15 for the Cougars. Again, game just underway. Lawrence Tech going three and out on possession number one. Cam Peterson to the left of Grant Gremmel. Three receivers set. Dandridge in motion. Play action fake. Gremmel looking long down the left. And contact incomplete. No penalty flag. Also incomplete at about the Lawrence Tech 25-yard line.
Grant Gremmel's pass.
It was Avante Vickers. He was the intended receiver, so incomplete, second down and 15.
Defense, number 7, 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic, first down.
Well, it was a penalty flag. All right, there we go. So 15-yard penalty on the play. All moves ahead to the Lawrence Tech 48-yard line. Back of the shotgun, twin receivers left, one to the right. Football comes back. Here is the handoff. Peterson, left side, crosses the 45 to the 44-yard line. Pickup of four on the carry.
Done by Chris Broughton.
Wet and misty afternoon and a somewhat sparse crowd for homecoming.
From the Blue Devil, 44-yard line.
Second down, we'll call it six. Four receivers set this time, twins to each side. Peterson moving from right to left in the shotgun backfield. Snap comes back. Gremmel to his right, looks, throws, has a receiver. Dandridge, he's got the first down and more to the 28-yard line. It's a 16-yard reception. Simple out pattern that time. Dandridge able to make the grab, turn it upfield for additional yardage. And the Cougars set up shop now, first down and 10 at the Lawrence Tech 33-yard line. Gremmel, three wideouts to his left. Snap comes back, looks left, throws, and the catch is made by Dandridge. Short gain on five, maybe 6 yards, down to the 27-yard line. He'll be knocked down immediately. It'll be second down and about four, with 11:15 showing on the first quarter clock. No score, but the Cougars are driving. Paul Ray in a slot to the near side right. Gremmel in the shotgun, twin receivers left. Gremmel takes the snap, play action, looking long down the right, throwing for McCall Ray, bobbles it. Did he catch it? No, he did not. Incomplete. It'll bring up third down and four for the Cougars.
It's a third down and four.
Ray had a step on the defender, but could not haul in the pass, so incomplete. Third down and four. And in weather conditions like this, if necessary, probably four down territory. Eli Patchett is the slot receiver now to the right side of the formation. Roslyn McEach in the wide out to the right side as well. Gremmel takes the snap, looking right, pressure coming, slides to his left, looking downfield, and is going to flip this one into the end zone. It is caught by Vickers, got it, touchdown! Vickers able to stay in bounds in the far corner of the end zone. A 27-yard touchdown pass number seven of the season for Grant Gremmel. And the Cougars score in their initial possession. They lead it 6-0 with the extra point attempt yet to come by Aiden Hostler. Derek Robb, the holder, snap comes back, kick is away, end over end, it is through the uprights, it is good, and St. Francis takes a 7-0 lead on Lawrence Tech. We'll come back after this short timeout on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Bishop Darcy Stadium, where the St. Francis Cougars lead Lawrence Tech 7-0. 27-yard touchdown pass from Grant Gremmo to Avante Vickers on the opening possession for the Cougars. Kickoff is on the ground, skipping to the far side, and this one will go out of bounds at around the 21-yard line. Penalty flag comes out, and Lawrence Tech has options. They can make a re-kick, make them re-kick, or they can take the ball at the 35-yard line. 7-0 our score. We're in the first quarter.
Kicking team, number 38. Ball be placed at the 35-yard line. First down.
They will take the 35-yard line option. This will be the second offensive possession of the game for Lawrence Tech. Again, they come in 1-5 on the season, 0-3 in the Mideast League. Dual running backs in the shotgun backfield. One receiver out to each side of the formation. Osman, two claps, calls for the football. They give straight ahead. Not much there for Devon Bentley as he cut it back over the middle. Sophomore, 5'11", 195, picked up two and a half yards on the carry. It'll bring up second down and long for Lawrence Tech. The drive by St. Francis, by the way, six plays, 58 yards. It took 2 minutes and 1 second off the clock. Twin receivers left. No one out wide to the right. Osman back to pass to his left, and the pass goes in and out of the hands of Jaden Rembert. Incomplete. It'll bring up third down and eight for the Blue Devils.
And brings up third down and eight.
It was resting at the Lawrence Tech 37-yard line. They need to get to the 45 to pick up a first down. Shifting of the receivers, Mauricio Jenkins flanked out wide to the near side now. 6'3", 230 pounds. Snap comes back. Osman looks to his right, loops it downfield, and overshoots the intended receiver, who had a step, but the pass ball's incomplete. Intended for Jaden Rembert, and another three and out for the Blue Devils with 9:59 left to go here in the opening quarter. 7-0 our score. St. Francis leads. Dropping back is Carter Dixon in punt formation. David Smith, he's one of those back deep for the St. Francis Cougars, back at his own 25-yard line. Cougars look like they're ready to bring pressure. Snap comes back about helmet high. Kick is away. Low end-over-end kick. It'll bounce into the hands of Smith, and he'll go down right away at the 30-yard line. And that's where the Cougars will take over. First down and 10. Change of possession. 9:54 to go. We're in the first quarter. 7-0 St. Francis leads in this homecoming edition of 2023.
The Cougars will start first and 10 on their own 30-yard line.
So first down and 10. It'll be Avante Vickers going out wide left. Crosley McEachin in the slot to the left side. Two running backs in the backfield. David Smith to the right of Grant Gremmel. Cam Peterson to the left. Play clock down to 20 seconds. Snap comes back. Here is the give. Straight up the middle. It is Cam Peterson, and he will grind away and pick up yardage to the 38-yard line. 8-yard gain on first down. Second down and two now for St. Francis. They're quickly right back at the line of scrimmage with Smith and Peterson again serving as dual running backs. Receivers in fairly tight to each side. Snap comes back. They hand off. Peterson straight up the middle. First down and more. He needed two, got about five. Ahead to the 43-yard line. New set of downs. First down and 10 for St. Francis.
And that results in a Glenbrook dodge.
First down. Brennan Stowe is the tight end now to the right side of the formation. Vickers wide to the right. Gremmel, play action, back to pass, long down the left, and overshoots Vickers. Vickers was at about the 30. The ball lands at the 25, incomplete. It'll bring up second down and 10. Second down and 10. Vickers catching a touchdown pass last week in the win over Siena Heights. Cougars with 2 fourth quarter touchdowns to pull away for the win, 42-28. Their third straight victory after an 0-2 start. Trips to the left side of the formation. There's the handoff, David Smith, and he is not going to get far at all. He is hit after a gain of a yard and a half, maybe. And that's going to be it. Michael White, the junior defensive tackle, 6'5", 250. He was in on the stop. So third down, we'll call it 8 for St. Francis.
Brings up third down and 8.
A.J. Dandridge out wide to the far side. Trips to that left side. Grimmel back to pass. Has to step up in the pocket. Has some room now, looks, throws, has Dandridge, he juggles it, and it falls incomplete at the 31-yard line. And the Cougars will have to send out the punting unit.
It's incomplete and brings up fourth down.
So fourth down and 8, with 8:10 left to go, first quarter, St. Francis leads 7-0. Derek Robb will drop back to about the 30-yard line, so he'll get it at about the 33. Tyler Garrett, the freshman, back deep for Lawrence Tech. He's at his own 24-yard line. Snap comes back about waist high. Kick is away. Nice kick. It'll turn over and land at about the 16-yard line, and is saved inbounds. Racing downfield to save it for St. Francis. Let's see if we can get the number here. I believe that was Kevin Ford who was able to keep inbounds. Like that was going to take a big hop into the end zone. But instead, Lawrence Tech will start off deep in their own territory. Matter of fact, their own 3-yard line. Change of possession, 8:01 to go first quarter. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 7-0.
Lawrence Tech will start first and 10 on
their own. Vaughn Bentley is now the running back. Twin receivers left, one to the right for the Blue Devils. Osman standing in his own end zone. Looks, throws to the right as a receiver. Pass is caught very near the first down marker. In fact, it should be a first down. Mauricio Jenkins makes the grab. Let's see where they say he is down. Oh, they will move the sticks as the ball is going to be down at the 13-yard line. Needed 10, got 10. It'll be first down and 10. Motion coming out of the backfield. Osman back to pass. It'll swing pass. It is caught, but nothing doing that time. Cougars were able to sniff that one out. Ben Britton, the running back, was the receiver. Braden Payne, he'll get credit for the tackle that time. It's going to be a loss of one on the play. So second down and 11. backfield. Devontae Bentley, the lone running back. And the snap goes through Osman's legs. He picks it up, throws to his left, and just ditches it out of bounds. There was a receiver in the area. Jaden Rembert. St. Francis wanted intentional grounding, but Rembert was right there. So incomplete and third down now and a long 11.
Hard to barely miss that throw.
Really?
Third literally, well, like
6:45 to go. We're in the first quarter on a rainy Saturday afternoon in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Four running backs in the shotgun backfield. Twin receivers to the right, one left. Britton in motion out of the backfield. Osman going to swing it to his right. Britton has it. Tries to make a man miss, but he is going nowhere. As he is dropped almost immediately. That will end the drive very quickly. Looks like Trayshawn Jones was one of those there to stop him. So fourth down and nine, and on comes the punting unit again. Carter Dixon will kick it away, standing very near his own goal line. One of those back, again, David Smith for St. Francis, and he's right at the 50-yard line. Call Ray is the other return man. Snap comes back, helmet high, kick is away, end-over-end kick. And it will go out of bounds in Lawrence Tech territory.
There's a penalty marker on the field.
There's a penalty flag down on the field. As it stands right now, the ball is at the 40-yard line. We shall see what the penalty is about. 5:56 to go, first quarter. 7-0, St. Francis leads. Officials talking it over between the 50 and 45 yard line. St. Francis on the road next week at Marion.
I saw them fighting and I think it got in there.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Kicking team, number 3, 15 yard field day from the end of the kick. It'll be 15-10.
So 15 yards against Lawrence Tech. That should march it all the way down to the 25-yard line, where St. Francis will take over first down and 10. Lawrence Tech hitting the road again next week at Siena Heights.
After the penalty, the Cougars will start first and 10 on the Lawrence Tech 25-yard line.
So outstanding field position for St. Francis. Back in the shotgun is Grimmel. Crosland McEachin wide out to the near side. Here's a handoff to David Smith, and he is in trouble, and down he goes in the backfield. He was hit almost immediately at the 30. Somehow spun forward to about the 29-yard line, and even so, it's a loss of 4 on the play. Second down and 14, nothing but white jerseys as soon as he took the handoff. Lawrence Tech in the white jerseys, white helmets, blue pants, blue numerals. St. Francis in the blue and white.
Did you know about the SAC?
Second down and 14. Emil in the shotgun. Snap comes back. He's back to pass. Looks, throws, and it's picked off. Picked off on the far side off a deflection. Andrew Perkins, the safety. He was able to pluck it out of the air. And just like that, the ball goes back to Lawrence Tech. Change of possession. 5:12 left to go. We're in the first quarter. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 7-0. And the Blue Devils will come back out on offense. St. Francis, Cougars scoring on their initial possession of the game. 6 plays, 58 yards, 27-yard touchdown pass from Gremmel to Avante Vickers. But that's been it so far. Meanwhile, Lawrence Tech has not crossed the midfield line. In fact, they haven't come close to the midfield line. This is their best starting field position, or equals it, of the ball game. Osman back to pass, looking right, and down he goes. Now, he was was hit and dropped almost immediately on the play.
Austin sacked by 91, James Matthews.
James Matthews, 5'11", 255. He came and got the sack. So second down and 17 after that, with the ball resting between the 27 and 28 yard line. It's been a struggle so far for Lawrence Tech offensively. Snap comes back, Osman back to pass, pressure coming, dumps it off, and it's dropped at the 30 yard line. Jaden Rember juggled it, wasn't going far anyway, would have been hit right there for a 2 yard gain. So third down and 17. Clock is stopped with 4:27 left to go in the first quarter. 7-0 as St. Francis leads. As far as yardage, well, not much for either team right now. Osman back on third and long, and down he goes again. That was Nate Tellum on the linebacker blitz. He brought him down for another loss, all the way back to the 20-yard line. That'll bring up fourth down and about 25, and on comes the Lawrence Tech punting unit. Right now, Lawrence Tech has negative yards on the afternoon when you factor in the sacks. Carter Dixon back to kick it away. He's at his own 5 yard line. Snap comes back. Kick is away. Turns over nicely. Will be fielded by David Smith at the 39 yard line as they block 45 to the 50 yard line. It'll be pushed out of bounds inside Lawrence Tech territory. Looks like they'll put it down right at the 50. So first down and 10, change of possession. 3:37 left to go in the first quarter. St. Francis 7, Lawrence Tech nothing. Again, good starting field position for the St. Francis Cougars. We're averaging 27 points per contest, averaging 361 yards per ball game, 140 on the ground, 221 through the air. 1-3 straight after an 0-2 start. Two running backs in the shotgun backfield, one to each side of Grant Gremmel. This time it's Cam Peterson who gets the give, busts a tackle or two inside the 45-yard line to the 43. It'll be a 7-yard pickup on first down and 10. So second and 3 for St. Francis. Vickers going out wide to the left, our far side of the formation. Both running backs stay in the shotgun backfield. Snap comes back. It is Smith, sheds a tackle, and he is going to break another, and somehow gets back to the line of scrimmage, plus maybe a yard or two. Like he was going to be tackled for a 4 or 5 yard loss. And instead, he turns it into, let's see where they put it down. They'll say he was out at the 46-yard line. Well, initially, it looked like they put it down at about the 42, but third down now and 6. Motion out of the backfield, that's Eli Patchett. Gremmel back to pass, sets up the screen. Peterson has it, 40, 35-yard line, and he'll be knocked down just across the 35. Nice one-handed snag by Peterson on the screen pass. That'll be enough for a first down. As he takes it to the 35, it's a gain of 9 yards. First down and 10, St. Francis. 2 minutes left in the opening quarter. 7-0, St. Francis. Back in the shotgun is Gremmel. Twin receivers to his right, snap comes back. He hands off. And Hassan Lambert from Northside High School takes it ahead to about the 30-yard line. Pick up a 5 on the play. Should be second down at about 5. It has been running back by committee so far this season for the Cougars. We're talking per game, sometimes 6, 7, 8 ball carriers handling the football. This time, not much there at all, as he is going to be dropped for a yard loss. So Lambert goes down for a yard loss, 3rd down and 6 now. New line of scrimmage is the Lawrence Tech 36-yard line. Under a minute left to go. We're in the opening quarter. 7-0. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech. Lambert remains in the backfield to the right of Gremmel. Ball comes back. Play action. Gremmel over the middle. Has the receiver. It's Vickers. He's got it at the 5. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, St. Francis. A 31-yard touchdown pass from Grant Gremmel to Alante Vickers. Second touchdown pass in the first quarter for Gremmel. And the Cougars jump up 13-0 with 39 seconds left to go in the opening quarter. Aiden Hostler will come on to attempt the extra point. Derek Robb, the punter, is the holder. Snap is down, kick is away, kick is through the uprights, kick is good. 14-0 St. Francis, late first quarter. We're back in just 30 seconds on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Coming 2023 for St. Francis, and the Cougars off to a good start as they lead Lawrence Tech 14-0. A pair of touchdown passes in the first quarter by Grant Gremmel. 2 extra points by Aiden Hostler. Here we are, 14-0. Alante Vickers catching both touchdown passes, 27 yards, and the latest, a 31-yarder. Hostler tees it up at the 35-yard line. Defense certainly has held Lawrence Tech in check so far. In fact, Lawrence Tech with negative 8 yards on 13 plays. Meanwhile, Cougars have snapped off 19 plays. They have 109 yards of total offense. They turn it over once. 86 yards through the air. Kick is away, end over end. And this will bound into the end zone for a touchback. So touchback, ball coming out, first down and 10, Lawrence Tech, and they trail 14-0. With 39 seconds left to go in the first quarter. And the scrimmage will be the 25-yard line. Alex Osman, it's been a rough start for him. He's been sacked 3 times. He's completed 3 of 7 passes for 12 yards. Gremmel, 5 of 10, 86 yards, 2 touchdowns and 1 interception. Snap comes back. Here's the handoff. Busting a tackle or two, Devon Bentley. He'll go out on the far side. Does pick up a little bit of yardage, it would appear. Well, they'll say he just got back to the line of scrimmage. And that very well might have been the final play of the opening quarter. Tech does not seem in any hurry to snap the football again, although they could if they wanted. Down to 8 seconds. Down to 5 seconds. And they do get it off. Osman back to pass, over the middle. Pass is in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, Jane Rembert. Incomplete, and the first quarter comes to a close. After one, it's St. Francis 14, Lawrence Tech nothing. We're back after this on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. St. Francis 14, Lawrence Tech nothing.
side? Oh.
That one. Now,
play resumes. It'll be second down. Make that third down. Right now for Lawrence Tech. It has been a struggle so far offensively. Starting quarter number two. Osman back in the shotgun. Snap comes back. Looks over the middle. Throws and no one is home. Incomplete. Pass balls to the turf at about the 45-yard line. The nearest receiver was Jalen Wallace. So another three and out for the Blue Devils. Out comes the punting unit and Carter Dixon. And the Cougars will send back McCall Ray and David Smith. We're in dual safety at about the 32-yard line. Cougars have gotten some pressure on the punter, Carter Dixon. He has had a busy afternoon.
For Lawrence Tech, they can use that light blue.
Snap comes back. Kick is partially tipped and will go out of bounds. Let's see where they put it down. But once again, the Cougars are going to have outstanding field position. Might have been tipped. Might have just gone off the side of his foot. Pressure was coming and it's tough to say just looking at the big scoreboard. But the rush was on again. The Cougars will claim possession at the 37-yard line in Lawrence Tech territory. First down and 10.
The Cougars will start
early in the second quarter. St. Francis looking to add to a 14-0 lead. Kremel surrounded by David Smith and Cam Peterson. Play action. He's back to pass. Long down the right. Has a receiver. Caught. Touchdown. Bosley McEachin from 37 yards out. McEachin was fairly well covered. He was able to snag the pass right at the goal line. Touchdown St. Francis. Third touchdown pass of the first half by Greg Gribble. And it's a 20-0 lead. With the extra point attempt yet to come off the foot of Aiden Hostler. So a one play, 37-yard drive. Kick is away. Kick is good. 21-0. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech. We're early in the second quarter. 14-42 to go. We'll come back after this on WGL Radio. A one-play, 37-yard drive. Grant Gremmel to Crosley McEachin for the touchdown. Aiden Hostler's kick was good. 21-0, St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech with 14:42 to go in the second quarter. Third touchdown pass of the first half by Grant Gremmel. also has 27 yards to Avante Vickers and a 31-yarder to Vickers. Kickoff is on the ground, picked up at about the 26-yard line, coming near side 30-yard line, and that is going to be it. Just not much there at all for Lawrence Tech. On the return, that was Charles Tiggert, and on the stop for the St. Francis Cougars on special teams, looks like that was Jaden Evans. So Lawrence Tech coming back out. They've not been able to move the football at all this afternoon. In fact, they have punted five times already in the game. So far, Lawrence Tech has rattled off 16 plays for negative 8 yards. Osman turns, hands off. Davidson has an alley on the far side, gets to the 40-yard line. They'll be chased out of bounds on that far side, but by far, that is the most productive play of the afternoon by Lawrence Tech. It'll be a pickup of 11 and a Blue Devil first down. Well, will be put down at the 43-yard line.
First down, Lawrence
down at 10. One wide out to each side of the formation. Twin running backs in the shotgun backfield. St. Francis with four down linemen. Here's the give. Davidson sidesteps a tackler to left side. Going to weave ahead to about the 49-yard line. Pickup of 6 on the play. They tell him one of those in the area for St. Francis. So second down and 4.
8-6 brings up second and 4.
Right now, Lawrence trying to keep the football on the ground. They've been bottled up here this afternoon. Aiden Ewers has checked in at a safety spot for St. Francis. Off opposite side, and just not a whole lot there at all. Maybe a yard or so to the 50-yard line. I'll bring up third down and about 3 for the Blue Devils. They're looking for their first. They'll make that third down of the game. So far, 1 by passing, 2 by rushing. Third down, we'll call it 3. Ball is squarely at the 50-yard line. Strong side of the formation is to the right. Osman back to pass, looking right. Throws, has the tight end. He's not going to get there. Nothing doing that time. As they tried that short flip out to Logan Tackett. He was brought down almost immediately. Kevin Ford able to make the tackle that time.
Spike up third down and 3.
Noticeable size differential.
Hoover 49-yard line.
It'll bring up fourth down and 3, and on comes the Lawrence Tech punting unit once again. Carter Dixon on for punt number 6 in the first half. Played 3 minutes into the second quarter. Kick is away, high hanging kick. This one will bound into the end zone for a touchback. So change of possession, 11:56 to go. We're in the second quarter. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 21-0.
Who's
joining us on this Saturday afternoon, despite the rain. 3 touchdown passes by Grant Dremel. These are not short flips either. 27 yards to Avante Vickers, 31 yards to Vickers, and then 37 yards to Crosley McEachin. A lot of umbrellas out here at Bishop Darcy Stadium. Kind of a misty afternoon. Heavier rain moving through earlier. It off. David Smith bounces off a tackler or two, moves the pile ahead close to the 24-yard line. Pick up a 4 on the play. It'll be second down and 6. men's soccer here tonight at 7 against Goshen College. The alumni men's soccer game is played here this morning. Busy day at Darcy Stadium. Snap comes back. Smith again. Smith able to push the pile ahead for a first down and much more. In fact, he's still going. Ball is across the 35, across the 40, and he's up to the 44-yard line. That's a 20-yard gain on the play. He just would not go down.
There's a penalty marker.
And we have a penalty marker on the far side of the field, way away from the play. As it stands, it was a 20-yard run with about 10 or 12 solely on David Smith. But the officials talking it over. Let's see what we've got here. And the flag came in way away from the play.
Assisting the runner, offense. Number zero, 5 yard penalty, the end of the run, still be first down.
So assisting the runner, you can have the push, but you can't assist the runner. 5 yard penalty, ball goes back to the 39-yard line. They will need to move the sticks. Still a first down. Is it? Bremel back to pass, looking long down the right, has a receiver, and it is incomplete. Intended Bremel's for McCall Ray, running step Ray for step was Chris Broaden. Ball's incomplete ahead of the 20-yard line. It'll be second down and 10. Well, it was indeed a first down. And the 5 yard assisting the runner penalty. You have to dig deep into the rule book for that one. Tight end to the near side is Brennan Stowe. Snap comes back. David Smith to the right side. He'll be pushed out of bounds near the first down marker. In fact, it appears he might have it. No assistance that time. 10-yard gain, first down. Now the Cougar ground game starting to make some noise. Smith, 6 carries, 29 yards to this point. Nose of the football is resting at the 50-yard line. Clock is moving. 10 and 30 left to go until halftime. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 21 to nothing. A.J. Dandridge in motion from right to left. Bremel back to pass. Looking long, down the left, has a receiver. Vickers made the grab at the 15. He'll be knocked down inside the 10. 37-yard completion to Avante Vickers, who has had a field day in the Lawrence Tech secondary this afternoon. 3 receptions, 100 yards, 2 touchdowns already by Avante Vickers. The ball's at the 8-yard line, so first and goal. Bremel back to pass, loops it near side, incomplete. And with good defensive position, that was cornerback John Webster that time with a near quarter of the end zone, second down and goal from the 8. Stops the clock with 9:39 to go until halftime. Cam Peterson now checks into the backfield. Twin receivers to the right side, one of them Eli Patchett. Handoff, Peterson up the middle. Peterson runs into the official, runs him over, touchdown. An 8-yard touchdown run by Cam Peterson. And the Cougars lead 27-0 with 9:34 left to go until halftime.
The
official is up there. The family is okay, but he took the brunt of that Dan Peterson run. snap is down, kick is away, end over end. It is good. St. Francis goes out to a 28-0 lead over Lawrence Tech. We have 9:34 to go until half. And we'll come back after this timeout on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. To nothing, St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech, 9:34 to go until halftime. The Cougars have won three straight, but in each of those three victories, they have gotten off to a slow start, and then really hit the gas in the second half. It's been the reverse of that today, with four first-half touchdowns, three touchdown passes by Grant Rimmel, 27 and 31 yards to Avante Vickers, 37 yards to Crosley McEachin, and the latest touchdown, an 8-yard run by Cam Peterson right up the middle. Kickoff. Hits the deck at about the 12-yard line, picked up on the run, and this is, well, the returner is still on his feet. It looked like for a second that he was in a big trouble, but instead it was Ben Britton able to turn a negative into a positive.
On the stop of the Cougars.
If I say that, I mean he got it out to the 19-yard line. First down and 10. Everything going the way of the Cougars so far. Total yards, 11 for Lawrence Tech. 231 for St. Francis. Down and 10 for the Blue Devils. Line of scrimmage is their own 19-yard line. Hand off, C.J. Davidson, and not much there as he takes it ahead, maybe for a yard or so to the 20-yard line, it would appear. Clock moving as we approach the 9-minute mark here in the second quarter. 66 yards rushing so far for St. Francis. Negative 2 for Lawrence Tech. Osman turns, hands off. Not much there, yard or two at best.
C.J. Davidson,
the ball carrier. It'll be third down and long for Lawrence Tech. Defense has already forced six Blue Devil punts. Twin receivers left, one to the right. Osman takes the snap, steps up in the pocket, throws, has the receiver, has the first down. Busting a tackle and then getting ahead to about the 32-yard line that time is Jalen Wallace. So Wallace with the grab, about a 13-yard reception ahead of the 33. First down and 10. First down's hard to come by in this first half for Lawrence Tech. Play clock on the move, down to 15 seconds. Snap comes back, play action, a throw, catch, and some yardage on that far side.
Osman pass, complete to Wallace.
That's Jaden Wallace who makes the grab that time. Hunter Byanski with the stop for St. Francis. Pickup of 9 on the play, second down and 1. Now the Blue Devils need to get a bit of tempo here. Back at the line of scrimmage. Wynn receivers to the right side of the formation. Snap comes back. Here's the give to Davidson, and he's going to be spun down behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of about a yard on the play.
Tackled by 44, Shamar Smith.
That was Shamar Smith, the defensive end, 6'2", 250, out of Decatur Central High School. So third down now, called a very long two for the Blue Devils. And receivers right, one left. Jaden Rember to that far side or short side. Orange Tech moving from left to right on your radio dial. Hand off, Davidson struggles forward, busts a tackle, has the first down and more as he crosses into St. Francis territory.
CJ Davidson on the carry.
Isaiah Higgins ultimately with the stop. That'll be a first down.
Isaiah Higgins on the tackle. Results in the first down, Lawrence Tech.
About a 14-yard pickup on the run. That, I believe, is the longest running play of the afternoon. It is for Lawrence Tech. Davidson, six carries, 34 yards. Snap comes back. Play action. Osman throws far side. Pass is caught right near the first down marker. Jaden Rembert making the grab.
There's a penalty marker on the field.
Penalty marker is down. It's going to work against Lawrence Tech. It's going to be a holding call.
Holding. Offense. Number 54. 10-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Well, it'll be first down and 20 after the penalty. Well, let's march back to the Lawrence Tech 45-yard line.
As a result of the penalty, Lawrence Tech will have it.
Clock moving under 5.5 to go until halftime. Blue Devils have to get all the way to the St. Francis 35-yard line to move the sticks. Snap comes back. Handoff. It is Devon Bentley. Cuts it back over the middle. Picks up about 4 or 5 yards, and that's going to be it.
Devon Bentley, the ball carrier. Brought down by 48, Nate Talham, the Cougars.
Talham again on the stop. Linebacker, 6'4", 222-pound senior out of Franklin High School in Indianapolis. Ball at the 50-yard line. Osman takes the snap, turns, hands off. Davidson busts the tackle along that right side.
C.J. Davidson, the ball carrier.
We'll take it ahead to about the 42. Aiden Ewers on the stop that time for St. Francis. Pick up on the play of about 7 yards or so. Brings up third down.
It's now third and seven.
So third down and seven for the Blue Devils. And they need to get to the St. Francis 35-yard line. Under four to go until halftime. 28-0, St. Francis leads. Snap comes back. Osman looks to his right. Nothing there. Pressure coming. Throws now to the right side. Pass is juggled and I believe caught just inside the 35 at the 34. Making the grab is Jalen Wallace. And he should have enough to move the sticks. The throw under pressure that time by Alex Osman, the redshirt freshman. 5'11", 205.
Lawrence Tech will have a first and 10 on the Cougars.
First down and 10 that time. After the completed pass, which was juggled but then pulled in by Wallace. Snap comes back, play action. Osman, pressure coming, down he goes. It's like Connor Price with the second sack of the afternoon. Takes it back to the 41-yard line. We have a couple of players who are slow to get up. One is up and one is on the turf. So we do have an injury timeout with 2:59 left to go until halftime. University of St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech 28-0. three touchdown passes by Grant Gremmel and an 8-yard touchdown run by Cam Peterson. Gremmel, so far, 7 of 14, 165 yards, 3 touchdowns, and 1 interception. His favorite receivers so far, Avante Vickers, 3 receptions, 100 yards, 2 touchdowns. Rosley McEachin, a catch and 37, plus a touchdown. A.J. Dandridge, 2 catches and 17 yards. Cam Peterson, 5 carries, 32 yards and a touchdown. David Smith, 6 carries, 30 yards. And for Lawrence Tech, C.J. Davidson, 7 carries and 42 yards. Osman, 8 of 14 for 53 yards. The injured player is still down, being tended to by medical personnel. Tell you what, we'll take a timeout. We'll come back. This is Cougar Football on WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Player shaken up is starting running back C.J. Davidson, but fortunately, he's able to walk off the field under his own power. In fact, he's sort of jogging with a bit of a hitch back to the sideline, so that's good to see. 2:59 left to go until halftime. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech 28-0. Blue Devils, when play resumes, will have it second down and 16, back at the 41-yard line. Snap comes back, and now it's on the turf, and it looks like it will be covered up by Lawrence Tech back at the 45-yard line. So a loss of 5. On the mishandled exchange,
the Osmond fumble.
That'll make it third down and about 21. Line of scrimmage to 45. First down marker is at the 24.
Brings up third down and 21. From the Cougar 45-yard line.
One receiver's left, one to the right. On the nearest side to the right is Jaden Rember. Snap comes back. Osmond rolling to his left. Looks, throws, incomplete. He was under all sorts of pressure, though, and had to get rid of it in a hurry. Incomplete.
Austin's pass and Jennifer Tackett is incomplete.
So incomplete. So Marquise Cross was one of those in there defensively. And once again, the Lawrence Tech punting unit comes out on the field with 2:10 left to go until halftime.
In punt formation for the
McCall
Blue Devils,
Ray, standing back at about his own 10-yard line. David Smith joins him in that area. Carter Dixon waiting for the snap at his own 41-yard line. It's back, kick is away, end over end. Grab by McCall, fair catch at the 10-yard line. And that's where the Cougars will take over first down and 10. Change of possession, 2:06 to go until halftime. It's St. Francis 28, Lawrence Tech nothing.
From their own 10-yard line.
Just tuning in this afternoon, Grant Gremmel, 3 touchdown passes, 1 interception, gives him 9 touchdown tosses for the season, 2 of them going to Avante Vickers. plus one to Crosley McEachin. Cam Peterson, an 8-yard touchdown run. He has 5 carries and 32 yards. Cougars enjoying a rather sizable advantage in terms of total yardage, and we'll go over all of that at halftime. Gremlin the shotgun, he's back to pass. Looking, there's a long on the left and no one is home. It is incomplete, out of bounds at about the 32-yard line.
Grimmel's pass is incomplete and brings up second down.
Second down. I'll tell you, the yardage advantage, it's almost 4-1 at this point in favor of St. Francis. Things get a bit tougher next week as the Cougars hit the road to play Marion University, ranked number 5 in this week's poll. Gremmel back to pass, steps up in the pocket, now takes off and slides down close to the 15-yard line. There is a penalty flag back at about the 3. So we will see what the flag is all about. We're talking with Avante Mitchell, seeing what he wants to do, so this will work apparently against the Cougars.
Holding, offense, number 77, half the distance, Reigns, second down.
Now that should put the football back at the 5-yard line. So second down and 15, Cougars have the ball in the shadow of their own goal line. Twin receivers to each side of the formation. Snap comes back. Delayed handoff. That's Lambert, and Lambert is going to be spun down behind the line of scrimmage. There's nothing doing there for Hassan Lambert. He is dropped for about a 2-yard loss on the play. That'll bring up third down and 17. Cougars need to get just across their own 20-yard line to get a first down. Play clock down to 10 seconds. Gremmel surveys that Lawrence Tech defense. Snap comes back. He's back in his own end zone. Looks, loops it. It is caught. Nope, incomplete in the far side. Would have been short of the first down anyway at about the 18-yard line. So on comes the St. Francis punting unit with 1:02 left to go into the halftime break. 28-0. St. Francis on top of Lawrence Tech. Eric Robb cannot take a step backward. If he does, he'll be out of the back of the end zone. Tyler Garrett back in single safety at his own 45-yard line. Kick is away by Robb. It is a short kick that takes a Lawrence Tech bounce. And then, as you see on the turf, takes another strange bounce and goes all the way to the 41-yard line. So, 38-yard punt, 50 seconds left to go until half. 28-0, St. Francis leads. Lawrence Tech, so far, 62 total yards on 33 plays. Most of those yards coming to the air when you factor in sacks. Receivers left, one to the right. Alex Osman is the quarterback. Snap comes back, and he's back. Looking, pressure coming, throws, incomplete, nearly picked off over the middle. I believe that was Nate Tellum who had his hands on it, but Osman had to get rid of it. There was just no one open. Second down and 10. 44 seconds left to go until half. Breezy, misty. It is a wet autumn afternoon at Bishop Darcy Stadium. Homecoming 2023. Snap comes back. Osman back to pass over the middle, has a receiver, and the completion is made to Jaden Rembert. And he will be downed at about the 21-yard line. So a 20-yard completion and a timeout on the field. We'll keep things right here with just 39 seconds left to go until halftime. Orange Tech, 1-5 on the season, 0-3 in the Mid-East League. They'll head to Siena Heights next to Saturday. USF, the Cougars trying to improve to 4-2 on the season. Again, they've won three straight, looking to improve to 3-0 in the Mid-East League. They will hit the road to Indianapolis next week to take on number 5, Marion. A game in Indy, it is a 1:05 kickoff. You can hear it here on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM at 105.5 FM. High school football on Fridays, USF football Saturdays, Chicago Bears football on Sundays. Matter of fact, the Bears and the Vikings at 1 o'clock tomorrow. Bob and Tom, Monday through Friday in the morning, local news, sports, and weather, plus CBS Radio News, all here on WGL. They resumes, new set of downs, first and 10 at the St. Francis 21-yard line. Play action by Osman. Scrambles to his right, dumps it off. Pass is complete. And slipping ahead for some yardage, Jaden Wallace.
Osman's pass complete to number 7, Jaden Wallace.
And the Blue Devils will burn their second timeout.
Timeout, Lawrence Tech, their second.
Nice job there as Osman found his safety valve. Krayshawn Jones was able to slow him up on the play. Play resumes, it'll be second down and 6. Ball's at the 17-yard line, 27 seconds left to go into a halftime break. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech, 28-0. Last night on WGL, Snyder wrapping up an 8-1 regular season with a 35-0 win over Wayne. The Generals finished the season 5-4. Playoff action, including Carroll at Warsaw, can be heard on WGL, and that game will be simulcast as well on Z93.9. Now that's October 27th, so a week from this coming Friday, that game will hit the airwaves. Regular season complete in Indiana. Just across the border in Ohio, well, there's one more week left in the regular season. Then it's playoff football. Osman back to pass on second down and 6. Looks, throws, has a receiver. First down and more, and upended very quickly was Nick Robinette. He was brought down at the 2-yard line, so it's a 15-yard completion. And Lawrence Tech has burned their third and final timeout. So they are going to have to either have a couple of plays lined up or hope the ball gets in the end zone, because they're out of timeouts. They run and don't make it, they are going to be hard-pressed to stop the clock in time. This, by far, the most impressive drive by the Blue Devils in this game. Back before this drive, they had 62 total yards. And that was on 33 plays. It eclipsed the 100-yard mark in terms of total yards now with 101. We'll have the football inside the 5-yard line. First and goal, but just 20 seconds left to go until halftime. Cougars been able to get to Alex Osman 4 times. Sacked 4 times for a loss of 30 yards. They've induced 7 punts so far. And here we go after the final timeout. Osman back in the shotgun. Motion. He throw, and it is knocked down.
Osmond's pass intended for Rembert is incomplete.
So knocked down on that far side. And given credit for that should be Marquise Cross. Now St. Francis calls timeout.
St. Francis.
17 seconds left to go until halftime. 28 to nothing. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech. Cougars making sure everyone is on the same page as we get closer to halftime. We'll recap the scoring, we'll recap the numbers, and we'll look ahead for these two teams during the halftime show. That's all coming up. Chicago Bears in action tomorrow against the Minnesota Vikings. The game at Soldier Field. Kickoff is set for 1. You can hear it here on WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Looks like it's been a while since the Bears have played, but they did have the Thursday nighter against the Washington Commanders and turned into their first win of the season. Both teams are back out on the field. Second down from the 3-yard line. 17 seconds left to go. Osmond back in the shotgun. One receiver to each side. Snap comes back. Passed into the end zone. Incomplete. Braden Payne there defensively that time on Jaden Rembert. So third down and goal from the 3. 13 seconds left to go until half.
Pass is broken up by Braden Payne.
Substitutions by the Lawrence Tech Blue Devils. Third and goal from the 3. Whistle and another timeout by St. Francis.
Timeout, St. Francis.
This is the longest to 20 seconds, I think, in the history of football. The Blue Devils burned all 3 of their timeouts. St. Francis has burned 2 of theirs. But the Blue Devils are trying to make the most of this possession. They trail it 28 to nothing. And St. Francis will receive the second half kickoff. And the wind, by the way, is picked up at Bishop Darcy Stadium. As soon as I say that, the flag just drops. But it's been a swirling wind on and off. Just tuning in, it is a misty afternoon. A lot of umbrellas for the brave souls that came out to this one. Here we go, third and goal from the 3. Osmond back in the shotgun, Devon Bentley to his right. Twin receivers to the right. Here's the handoff, Bentley, and he's not going to get there. He is stopped after a 1-yard gain.
Bentley, the ball carrier.
There's 1 second left on the first half clock. Some of the fans are ready for the halftime break. 1 second left to go until the break. But a nice goal line stand that time by the St. Francis Cougars. 4 plays from the 3-yard line. And Lawrence Tech comes up empty. Appears that Rembert will just take a knee. And he does. does so. And that is the first half here at Bishop Darcy Stadium in Fort Wayne. Two full quarters in the books. Our score, homecoming 2023. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 28-0. Stick around. Our halftime show is next on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM.
That way. Okay, turn mine off. Okay, I'm trying to work the.
Hey, Cougar fans, now you can show your team spirit while making everyday purchases. Midwest America Federal Credit Union offers a University of St. Francis debit card, and with each checking account purchase you make, money is earned for the school. It's available on all checking accounts, and you can take your new card home with you the same day. With 15 area locations and multiple digital banking options, your Midwest America checking account is convenient and easy to manage. Get your USF debit card today. Cougar fans, please remember that the campus of USF is a tobacco-free environment. Do your part by not using tobacco products anywhere on the campus of USF. Thank you for your cooperation. OmniSource is one of North America's largest processors and distributors of scrap and secondary metals. We collect, process, resell, and trade a wide variety of ferrous and non-ferrous scrap. At Omni, we're all set for the environment. All in for our team and all in for our partners and all in for you. To learn more about selling scrap to Omni or to explore potential career opportunities, visit omnisource.com.
It is halftime at Bishop Darcy Stadium on this cool and wet Saturday afternoon. Scott Trunzel filling in for Joe Parson today. 28-0, St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech in Mideast League play again on this Saturday afternoon. And as you can imagine, as the score would indicate, it has been all St. Francis here this afternoon. Let's recap the scoring in the first half. Two of the touchdowns by St. Francis coming in the first quarter of play. It was Ovante Vickers hauling in a 27-yard touchdown pass from Grant Grimmel. And that capped off a six-play, 58-yard drive that took 2 minutes and 1 second off the clock. The Aiden Hostler kick was good, 7-0. St. Francis with 10:45 to go in the first quarter. St. Francis struck again with 39 seconds left to go in the opening period. Grimmel this time hooking up with Ovante Vickers from 31 yards out. And that capped off a six-play, 50-yard drive that took just under 3 minutes, 2 minutes and 58 seconds to be exact. And again, with 39 seconds left to go in the first period, that made it 14 to nothing.
Hey, how's the camera, man?
Into the second quarter, Crosley McEachin catching a 37-yard touchdown pass from Grant Rimmel. The Aiden Hostler kick, good. And that was a one-play, 37-yard drive. And with 14:42 left to go in the second quarter, that made it 21 to nothing. St. Francis, those two touchdowns coming within about a minute's time. Then, with 9:34 left to go in the second quarter, Cam Peterson took a handoff and raced straight up the middle, pulled over the official in the end zone. He scored on an 8-yard run, and that capped off a 7-play, 80-yard drive that took 2:22 off the clock. Aiden Hostler's PAT was good, and that took us to 28 to nothing. Lawrence Tech did drive inside the St. Francis 3-yard line shortly before halftime. Got down there with 20 seconds left, had four cracks at it, but were denied by the Cougars. They did not give up any yardage on four plays from the 3-yard line, and the first half clock ran out.
You can go to the press box if you want to warm up.
Cougars actually had to take a knee with 1 second left, but that goal line stand, an impressive one, and that takes us to our halftime score of 28 to nothing, St. Francis. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll start to run down the numbers, but as you can imagine, those are solely in favor of the St. Francis Cougars. This is Cougar Football on WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM.
I saw him like right after I got my...
Up here.
No, it's not that.
Just need your gloves and layer up and remember that for next time you
count. Thank you.
John Truxell filling in for Joe Parson on this Saturday afternoon. We're at halftime where St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 28-0. Before we take a look at the numbers, let's get an update from the man himself, Joe Parson. Always good to hear from Joe Parson, and Joe, certainly we are keeping you in our thoughts and prayers, and here is to a speedy recovery. We would love to hear you back here by the end of the month, if at all possible, but Joe on the mend, and Joe recouping at home now, that's certainly good news, and we'll continue to get updates from Joe as warranted. 28-0, our score at half. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech. Let's take a look at some of the numbers. First of all, in terms of total yardage, Lawrence Tech has rattled off 41 plays for exactly 100 yards. St. Francis, 31 total plays in the first half and 232 yards. By the way, many of Lawrence Tech's yards came in that final drive that came up short right before halftime. Some of the other numbers. Well, the Blue Devils have had to punt seven times in the first half. Just two punts so far by St. Francis. In terms of penalties, not a whole lot of them so far. Three for 40 yards by Lawrence Tech, 318 yards for St. Francis. Time of possession, that's definitely in favor of the Cougars. They held the ball for 27 minutes and 4 seconds in the first half, 17 minutes and 54 seconds for the Blue Devils. Third down efficiency, the Lawrence Tech Blue Devils converting 3 of 11 first downs, 2 of 4 for St. Francis. Meanwhile, Lawrence Tech 0 of 1 on fourth down, and that came right before halftime. Also first downs, well, it is St. Francis with 12, Lawrence Tech with 7. Taking a look at some of the individual numbers in the first half for Lawrence Tech, Alex Osman, the quarterback, 11 of 22, 92 yards, no touchdowns, and no interceptions. Osman, when you factor in sacks, 5 carries, and negative 30 yards. However, C.J. Davidson, before going down with an injury, 7 carries and 42 yards. His longest run was 14 yards. Total on the ground for St. Francis to make that Lawrence Tech at the half, 19 carries and 8 yards. Receiving-wise, Jaden Rembert, 2 receptions, 30 yards. Nick Robinette, 1 catch, 10 yards. Same for Mauricio Jenkins. Ben Britton with 2 receptions and 2 yards. Jalen Wallace with 4 receptions and 39 yards. For St. Francis, Grant Grimmel, 7 of 16 in the first half, but 165 yards, 3 touchdowns, and 1 interception. That was off a tip. The receiving totals go like this. Avante Vickers, 3 receptions, 100 yards, 2 touchdowns, and a long of 42. A.J. Dandridge, 2 catches, 17 yards. Cam Peterson, a catch and 11. That was on a one-handed pass on a screen. He was able to snag it with one hand and pick up a first down. And Crosley McEachin with a single catch and 37 yards, and that went for a touchdown. On the ground, it is Cam Peterson with 5 carries, 32 yards, and a touchdown. David Smith, 6 carries, 30 yards, with a long of 20. Son Lambert, 3 carries and 2 yards. Bailey Parker with a carry and a 3 yards in the first half. Derek Robb, a couple of punts, 90 yards, 45-yard average, not bad at all. And the kickoff returns, well, none of those so far for St. Francis. For Lawrence Tech, the long, that one was taken back 1 for 22 yards, but a lot of touchbacks in the first half. So there you have it, all of the numbers, including the scoreboard, favoring St. Francis as they lead 28-0. At homecoming 2023. The fans, what there are of them here this afternoon. Umbrellas, raincoats, rain gear. They have braved the weather conditions to watch this game. This is the second of three events in Darcy Stadium today. There was the alumni men's soccer game this morning. You've got this football game, which has a half to go. And then tonight, it's men's college soccer as St. Francis will take on Goshen College, and that is set for 7 o'clock, so it'll be under the lights, but a busy, busy day. All sorts of activities as well planned for homecoming weekend. Those events will continue into tomorrow. We will take a break, and we will continue on from Bishop Darcy Stadium. Our score at the half, it's St. Francis 28, Lawrence Tech nothing. We'll continue. This is your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Both teams back out on the field, warming up for the second half. As we get set for the second half, it is St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech at 28-0. You're just joining us, Grant Grimmel, with three first half touchdown passes, two of those to Avante Vickers. And again, St. Francis rolling in the first half to that 28-0 lead. A victory this afternoon would make it four straight for the USF Cougars as they hit the road next week to take on ranked Marion University. Marion ranked number four in this week's poll. That game in Indianapolis, that'll be a 1:05 kickoff next Saturday. You can catch it live on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. But the Cougars, again, looking to improve to 4-2 overall, and more importantly, 3-0 in the Mid-East League. Meanwhile, Lawrence Tech trying to avoid a 1-6 start. A loss this afternoon would drop the Blue Devils to 0-4 in Mid-East League play. And the two teams finishing warm-ups, getting final instructions, and we'll be getting the second half underway here very shortly. High school football on Fridays here on WGL. It's USF football on Saturdays. Chicago Bears football Sundays. Bob and Tom in the mornings, Monday through Friday. And, of course, local news, sports, and weather, plus CBS Radio News. It's all here on Fort Wayne's First, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM. You can also listen on 105.5 FM. The St. Francis Cougars will receive the football to begin the second half of play. We'll be getting things underway here in a very short fashion. Cougar defense, though, doing a nice job in the first half. Four sacks on the afternoon, number of quarterback hurries, and for the most part, they have kept Lawrence Tech all bottled up. Blue Devils did put together a drive right before half, got down to the St. Francis 3-yard line, but the Cougars then held on four straight downs from the three, in effect, running out the first half clock. St. Francis coming out to receive the second half kickoff. Eli Patchett is one of those going back. Also going back, looks like Drew Wheat, and he'll be down inside the 5-yard line at about the 3. Isaiah Higgins also going back deep to receive the kick, and now Lawrence Tech comes out of the field here to begin the second half of play. Glad you could join us on this Saturday afternoon. Again, the crowd here with the weather, as expected, we'll just say it is sparse. Some college football scores. Michigan, we're talking NCAA Division I here. Michigan leading Indiana at the end of 3, 38-7. Ohio State leading Purdue 34-0, and they're late in the third quarter in that ball game. Teeing up the football, it is Vincent Robison. He's perfect on the year when it comes to field goals and extra points. 9 of 9 PATs, 4 of 4 on field goal attempts. Here's his approach, kick is end over end, and we'll come down to Patchett at about the 16-yard line, coming near side, 25, 30-yard line, 35 to the 40, and he will take it up close to the 45-yard line. Eli Patchett with blockers and a head of steam, and he gets a nice return. Let's see where they put that football down. He started to his left, had a wall of blue jerseys ahead of him, and was able to take it ahead to the 45-yard line, and that's where the Cougars will start off first down and 10. It'll be A.J. Dandridge going wide to the right side. In the slot, it's Ovante Vickers. Brennan Stowe, the tight end, to the left side. Dual running backs flanking Grant Grimmel. Well, takes the snap, turns, hands off Cam Peterson left side, and he'll be slammed down to the turf after a 3-yard gain. Up off the stack, it is Andrew Perkins, the third, starting safety for the Blue Devils. So a 3-yard pickup. It'll bring up second down and 7. We're just underway in the second half. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 28-0. Twin receivers to the right. Here's the handoff, David Smith. Smith through the secondary. Smith puts his head and shoulders down, gets to the 40-yard line. It'll be a 12-yard pickup. And another St. Francis first down.
And that results in a blue rook dud.
Andrew Perkins, the safety on the stop that time. New set of downs for the Cougars. Grimmel takes the snap, turns, hands it off again. Smith picks and weaves through the middle and is going to pick up 6 yards or so, maybe 7, to the 33-yard line.
Perkins on the tackle.
the third straight time. Andrew Perkins, the leading tackler, with the stop. Back to pass, looks, throws, and the ball comes loose. Crosley McEachin almost had a circus catch at around the 25-yard line. So he had to reach back to get it, but the ball came loose as he hit the turf. So third down and three. Third and three. With Smith remains in as one of the running backs. A.J. Dandridge shot wide to the left side. Twin running backs in the shotgun backfield. Here's the handoff, Cam Peterson, and he is going to be wrapped up and dropped behind the line of scrimmage.
Cam Peterson, the ball.
Darian Murray, one of the linebackers, junior, 5'10", 200 pounds. He comes in to make the stop. It'll be a three-yard loss, and it'll bring up fourth down and six now from the Lawrence Tech 33-yard line. Dandridge out wide to the right. McCall Ray in the slot, along with Devontae Vickers. No one flanked out wide to the left side of the formation. Rimmel back to pass. Looks, throws, and that ball was tipped at the line of scrimmage, incomplete. And the Cougars turn it over on downs. Change of possession, 12:49 left to go, third quarter. Score remains St. Francis 28, Lawrence Tech nothing. This will be the first possession of the second half by the Lawrence Tech Blue Devils. Coming in, they're averaging just a shade under two touchdowns per game, 13.5 points, 313 yards per contest. So far, they've been held off the scoreboard and have 100 total yards. Osman at the shotgun with Devon Bentley to his right. Twin receivers to each side. Osman back to pass, looking left, throws. Grab is made, and not a whole lot there on that far side. Jalen Wallace made the catch, but he was hounded to the turf almost immediately. Sean Jones, one of those there. So it'll bring up second down. We'll call it about four or so. Turns out a six-yard gain. Osman with Bentley to his right. Here's the give to Bentley, left side, and he will be stonewalled just before he reaches the first down marker. Like he was in the clear and was going to get it. But nothing doing. Aiden Ewers had other ideas and stopped him a yard short. So it'll be third and one, ball resting just ahead of the 45-yard line. Three receivers to the right or wide side of the formation as the wind picks up again. Osman takes the snap. He's back to pass. Looks, throws. It is incomplete. Broken up on the play.
Osman's pass and Temple Rembert is incomplete.
Rembert was the intended receiver.
Bailey
Parker with the breakup that time, and that'll bring up fourth down and one. And it looks like the offense is going to stay out there. But the Blue Devils trail 28 to nothing with 11:34 left to go in the third. Twin receivers to each side. Osman back to pass. Pressure coming. Looks, throws, has a receiver, and has the first down. Jaden Rembert made the grab over the middle. Picked up about 9 yards or so. And that'll bring up first down and 10 in St. Francis territory at the 46-yard line. New set of downs after a fourth down conversion. Osman back to pass, rolls out to his right, flips it, catch is made, and a big stick there defensively by Bailey Parker. The receiver again was Jaden Rembert, but he paid for that reception. Did pick up the first down, gain of 12 on the pass play, but Parker came up with the big stick that time. Bailey Parker from East Noble High School, 6'3", 200-pound senior safety.
Trying to follow the ball.
34 is now the line of scrimmage in St. Francis territory. Osman Dual running backs in the backfield. It'll be Bentley who gets the give, cuts it back over the middle, keeps the pile moving, and will take it inside the 20 to the 29-yard line. Pick up a 5 on the play. So second down, we'll call it about 5 for the Blue Devils.
Hunter Byanski of the Cougars.
Hunter Byanski will get credit for the stop that time. Osman back in the shotgun. Two receivers to his left, one to the right. Play action and a quick flip, and the pass is caught once again. That is Rembert, and he is very close to the first down marker. As a matter of fact, he should have it.
Yeah.
He needed 5. They're eyeballing it, and now they'll say first down. So first down, new line of scrimmage is the 24-yard line. Clock is moving, 9:20 and counting. We're in the third quarter. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 28-0. The receivers to the right. Osman back to pass over the middle, and it is incomplete. A late penalty flag comes out on the near side. I believe that was Emmanuel Davis who broke up the pass. But let's see what the penalty is all about. Well, it looks like Lawrence Tech.
Man downfield. Offense, number 80. Five-yard penalty. Still second down.
Ineligible man downfield. Ball goes back to the 29-yard line. First and 15 now. Clock is stopped with 9:08 left to go in the third quarter. Twin receivers right, make that 3 of them, 1 to the left. Osman back in the shotgun. Back to pass, looks right, throws, short grab, and reception is made on that near side. Mauricio Jenkins with his second catch of the day. Back to the original line of scrimmage at about the 24-yard line. So 5-yard pickup. Treshawn Jones, one of those in on the stop. Osman now up to 15 of 28, 124 yards. Motion out of the backfield. Play action. Osman in trouble. Loops and flips it out, and I think that's intentional grounding. Nope, there was a receiver there as he pops up off the turf. Didn't look like there was a receiver as Osman got rid of the football. He was under heavy pressure that time. In any case, he's looking at third down and 10. The football just inside the 25-yard line in St. Francis territory. Cougars lead it 28-0.
There is no foul. British Brown. There is a receiver in here.
People didn't see the receiver. He had hit the deck right in front of the St. Francis bench. Fans still don't like it. Third down and 10. Osman back to pass. Pressure coming. He dumps it off to Bentley, and Bentley is going to be knocked down after a very short gain, maybe 3 or 4 on the play, and that's going to be it. Spencer Pate on the stop, that time for the Cougars. Pate, a 6'4", 265-pound senior out of East Noble High School. And it looks like the Blue Devils will send out the field goal unit. Vincent Robinson on the year, 4 out of 4 from field goals, on field goals, as long as 38. This will be a 42-yarder from the right hash mark into a somewhat swirling wind. Snap comes back, kick is away, and it's blocked. Kick was blocked that time. I believe that was Isaiah Higgins who got a hand on it. So Robinson misses his first field goal of the season. The Blue Devils remain scoreless. They trail 28-0 with 7:17 left to go in the third. 28-0, St. Francis with the advantage. Momentary timeout on the field. We'll keep things right here for you. Again, St. Francis on the road. We'll head to the Indy area to take on Marion next Saturday. It's a 105 kickoff. You can hear it on WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Line of scrimmage will be the Cougar 24-yard line. Grimmel coming up under center. Backs are split behind him. Here's the handoff. Drew Wheat, and on the jet sweep, he busts out of some tackles. Down the sideline, it's a foot race. 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Did he get in? Yes, he did. Touchdown. A 76-yard touchdown run on the jet sweep at the short side of the field. Drew Wheat won the foot race down the sideline. Got tripped up and stumbled ahead into the end zone for the score. Wow. Save that one for the highlight reel. Aiden Hostler on to attempt the extra point for the Cougars as they increase their lead to 34-0. Snap is down, kick is away, kick is through the uprights, and it is good. 35-0 St. Francis, a one-play, 76-yard drive, 7:01 left to go in the third, and we'll continue after this on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. On a 76-yard touchdown run down the home sideline. That came after the blocked field goal. St. Francis now leads Lawrence Tech 35-0 with 7:01 left to go here in quarter number three. Osler with the ball teed up at the 35-yard line. His approach, the kick is away. Low end-over-end sidewinder kick. That one hits the 10-yard line, picked up 15, 20, 25-yard line, some running room on the far side, and an open field special teams tackle applied that time by the Cougars. Nick Nondorf, I believe, from Cherubusco, was able to make the stop on the return that time for Lawrence Tech. We've seen him in the game from time to time. That was Tyler Garrett. So the Blue Devils will have it first down and 10 at their own 24-yard line. They trail 35-0. Shotgun backfield, twin receivers to the right, one left. Snap comes back. Here is the handoff, and not much there at all. We have not seen running back C.J. Davidson since the first quarter. He went down with an injury. Ben Britton gets the carry that time. Takes it off the left side for about 3 yards, and that's it. So second down and six. 6.5 to go. We're in quarter number three. 147 total yards for Lawrence Tech. 327 so far by St. Francis. There's a short pitch and catch. Mauricio Jenkins, the tight end, able to make the grab that time, but just not much there at all. A couple of yards at best before he's upended at the 29-yard line. It'll bring up third down and about five for the Blue Devils. Third and five, trips to the right. One receiver to the near side. Alex Osman, the quarterback. He's been under fire all afternoon. Snap comes back. Little screen set up, and it is incomplete. So it would appear another three and out, and out comes the punting unit for Lawrence Tech. This will be punt number eight by the Blue Devils this afternoon. McCall Ray and David Smith back in dual safety at about the 30-yard line. Carter Dixon back at his own 15, so we'll hit it at around the 18-yard line. Cougars have the line of scrimmage loaded up. And here they come. Kick is away, not a bad one all things considered. It will hit the turf and bounce right to David Smith in the vicinity of the 30-yard line. Let's see where they mark it down. But the rush was on. Give Dixon credit as he was able to get it away. Cougars will start off first down and 10 at their own 29. Change of possession, 5:33 to go. We're in the third quarter. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech 35-0. The road trip continues next week for Lawrence Tech as they head to Siena Heights. Rimmel going to come back out at quarterback. And it looks like Cougars have gone to the big backfield now, and Brett Wellington and Eli Patchett. They'll split behind Grimmel, who's under center. Tight formation. Grimmel back to pass, looking long down the right as a receiver out there, and it is incomplete on that far side. Running downfield. It was Colin McPeak. Noblesville. The intended receiver, but the pass was overthrown on the deep route. So second down and 10, 5:28 to go in the third. Cougars led 14-0 after one quarter, 28-0 at the half. Tight formation again, split backs, weed in motion, handoff, and barging forward for yards and a first down and more. I believe that was Brett Wellington. It was. He barged ahead to the 45-yard line, 16-yard pickup on second down and 10. Wellington, not a whole lot of carries this year, eight or nine, but four of those have resulted in touchdowns. Tight formation once again, backfield is split. Patchett in motion, little counterplay with Wheat coming left side. Juke move, and he's in trouble, and will get a yard, maybe two out of it. So he made the best out of a not-so-good situation. Couple of yards, second down and eight. Ball came loose. And the Cougars come out of the pile with it. It was Reeve Muncie who came out with it. Muncie, 6'5", 326 pounds, and a junior at a Carroll High School right here in Fort Wayne. Second down and eight, clock rolling as we approach the four-minute mark in the third quarter. Handoff, Patchett to the right side, cuts it back, head and shoulders down, runs over a tackler and takes it ahead to the 47-yard line. Pick up a five. It'll bring up what should be third down and about three. Cougars have gone to the smash mouth mode out of the old wing T look. Run a jet sweep, couple of off tackle plays, counter play.
Brings up third and two.
One in the slot, one receiver out wide to the right, split backfield. Handoff, and Wellington is not going to get it. He will be stopped right at the line of scrimmage on that left side. That'll bring up fourth down and a very short two. Maybe one. Looks like it's closer to one. Cougars keep the offense out on the field. Under three to go, third quarter. They lead 35 to nothing. Backfield again split. Wing T look. One receiver out wide to the right. Rimmel on the quarterback sneak, and he has got it. Why not? When you have an offensive line that goes 277, 326, 327, 270, and 312, you could run the quarterback sneak, and that's what they did. Needed a yard, got two.
And that results in a Glenbrook dud.
First down. New set of downs at the Lawrence Tech 44-yard line. That tight formation again, the old wing T look. Hand off. And a little bit of running room there on the jump sweep. Cam Peterson able to move it ahead for about 4 yards along that left side. Under two to go in the third quarter. Cougars trying to keep the clock rolling with that 35 to nothing lead. So second down and six. Again, tight formation with Patchett and Wellington, the running backs. Patchett in motion to the right, toss sweep to him. He has some blockers. 40, 35, 30, and he'll be tripped up and brought down at about the 25-yard line. A 15-yard gain on the toss sweep. There'll be another Cougar first down. Again, the Cougars going old school here in the third quarter. They relied on the ground game, and it has come through in a big way. New line of scrimmage, the 25-yard line. 65 ticks left on the third quarter clock. Backfield is split. Peterson as a wing. He's in motion. Handoff. And a mass of humanity moving down to the 20-yard line. Pickup of five on the play. Brett Wellington on the carry that time. And the Cougars will have to run one more play if they keep it on the ground. 30 seconds on the game clock, about 15 on the play clock. Backfield is split once again. Grimmel up under center. Here is a handoff. And not a first down, but a couple of yards. That was Ryan Walsh on the carry, and that should be the final play of quarter number three. We played three at Bishop Darcy Stadium. After three, our score, St. Francis 35, Lawrence Tech nothing. We'll come back after this on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio 1250 AM at 105.5 FM. Fourth quarter action ready to begin. The Cougars on the move. They have the football third down and two at the Lawrence Tech 18-yard line. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech 35 to nothing. Cougars have rolled up 215 rushing yards to this point. Rimmel comes up under center. Backfield is split behind him. Wheat in motion. Play action. Rimmel back. Looks, throws. Wide open. Patchett, touchdown. He came out of the backfield. No one picked him up. Touchdown, 18 yards. Touchdown pass number 4 for Grant Rimmel this afternoon. And the Cougars have extended the lead to 41-0 with the extra point attempt yet to come off the foot of Aiden Hostler. When I say wide open, I mean wide open. There was no one within 5 yards of Eli Patchett. So they pound, pound, pound with that running game and then score on an 18-yard play-action pass. Extra point on the way. It is through the uprights. It is good. 42-0 our score. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech. We will take a brief timeout. We'll come back after this. It's your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio, 1250 AM and 105.5 FM. Three left to go in this one. It's all St. Francis. Cougars leading Lawrence Tech 42-0. A season high 4 touchdown passes for Grant Rimmel. The latest one 18 yards to Eli Patchett. And that capped off a long drive, mainly on the ground, for the St. Francis Cougars. As they have rolled up 397 yards of total offense so far this afternoon. End over end kick grabbed at the 11 to the 15, 20 yard line. Tyler Garrett, head and shoulders down across the 35, close to the 39-yard line. And that's where the Blue Devils will start off first down and 10. Lawrence Tech coming in had lost 4 straight. They're about to drop to 1-6 on the season and 0-4 in the Mideast League. USF will improve to 4-2 and 3-0 in the Mideast League, 4 straight wins for St. Francis, barring a very large and unusual comeback. Osman in the shotgun, twin receivers to his left. Hands off to Bentley, and he is going to be dropped in the backfield. Looks like Connor Price was in there on the stop. He will say no gain in the play with forward progress, 2nd down and 10. So 397 yards for St. Francis, 149 yards by Lawrence Tech. Twin receivers left, a single receiver flanked wide to the right. Motion out of the backfield, screen pass coming, and the Cougars have this one diagnosed and broken up.
Osmond's pass completed on Bentley.
And even though he was tied up by a blocker that time,
Jake Majerski
fought off the block. He's out of Boone Grove High School. He fought off the block and stopped the play for about a 4-yard loss. So 3rd and 14 for the Blue Devils. Line of scrimmage, the 35-yard line. Osman back to pass. Pressure coming, and down he goes for the 5th time this afternoon. Connor Price was there, but I believe it was Ray Smith who gets the sack. And that'll bring up a 3-and-out, so on comes the punting unit. Carter Dixon back at his own 15-yard line. McCall Ray and David Smith, they're back with Ray at about the 45-yard line. Smith at the, let's say, the 33-yard line. Snap comes back to Dixon. It's a good one. Kick is away. turns over and will go out of bounds somewhere between the 30 and 35 yard line. We'll mark it out at the 33. Change of possession, 12:47 to go in the fourth. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech 42-0. Let us see if we see some different faces on this possession. Garrett Yoon will come out at quarterback. 5'11", 185. He's a sophomore. Hassan Lambert will be the running back next to him in the shotgun. Motion coming from right to left. Here is a handoff and a jet sweep and some running room along that near left side.
14, Carson Mumma, the ball carrier.
Carson Mumma, the ball carrier that time. And a jet sweep. Cougars have gone old school here in the second half, keeping that clock running with a 42-0 lead. Mumma's first carry of the afternoon. Yoon back in the shotgun, hands it off. This is Lambert. Lambert, the Northside High School product, takes it ahead for a yard or so to about the 39-yard line, maybe a 2-yard gain. It'll bring up third down and 4 for the Cougars. They need to reach the St. Francis 43 to move the chains.
Number 6, Sylvester Jones.
Yoon taking over for Grimmel out of Lawrenceburg, Indiana. Saw some action earlier in the season. Snap comes back and Yoon is back to pass. Throws, has a receiver, and the pass is caught on the near side, but that is short of the first down.
Complete to number 82, Drayton Shock.
Drayton Shock with the catch that time comes up a couple yards short. And we see some substitutions, but it does not look like the punting unit's coming on. Fourth down, actually a little less than 2. Mumma comes out wide to the right side of the formation. Yoon coming up under center. Lambert in motion, toss sweep to him. And with second effort, he will get the first down plus 1. And a late penalty flag comes in as well.
There's a penalty marker on the field.
So Lambert, able to put his head and shoulders down. Came in late, so I am guessing this is a post-play penalty. Let's see what we've got here.
Active play. Personal foul. Unnecessary run. Number 79. That 15-yard penalty will be from the end of the run. It'll be first and 10 on St. Francis.
Now it was post-play, but it was on St. Francis. So the first down stands, but it'll be first and long. 10:55 to go in the ball game. Cougars leading Lawrence Tech 42-0. Line of scrimmage is going to be the 30-yard line. Garrett Yoon in at quarterback in relief of Grant Grimmel, who tossed 4 touchdown passes this afternoon. That is a season high for the grad transfer. Yoon has his pass knocked down.
Garrett Yoon's pass broken up.
Getting in there defensively.
Brings up second and 10.
That was Dante Banton.
30-yard line.
6'4", 245, redshirt senior out of Florida. Second down, snap comes back. Lambert gets the give, breaks a tackle or two, gets back to the line of scrimmage, but that was an accomplishment because he was stopped, it appeared, 2 or 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage. So no gain, third down and 10. 10.5 left to go in the ball game. St. Francis will leave with a homecoming win and 4 straight victories. And we'll begin preparing for Marion University next Saturday at 1:05. Catch it on WGL. Snap comes back to Yoon on third and 10. Looks long down the right. Has two receivers, and it's caught. Carson Mumma with the reception in Lawrence Tech territory at the 47-yard line. So a 23-yard reception by Mumma. And the drive stays alive. Trips to the left side of the formation. Yoon calls for the football, hands it off. Lambert, left side, breaks a tackle or two, then will be shoved back by about three or four of the Blue Devils. He picked up about four, maybe five on the carry. Lambert getting a workout on this drive. The second down now, and about six for St. Francis. Lambert, six carries. I think that's seven carries and 32 yards now in the ball game. Well over 200 yards rushing by St. Francis this afternoon. Here is a little flip and some running room and a first down and more. As the Cougars continue to move the football down the field. That was Bodie Dickerson who had lined up in a slot. Took the short pass and was able to pick up first down yardage. Down to the 32-yard line. Yoon in the shotgun. Looks, throws, near side. Pass is caught again. Mumma with the reception. It's going to be a very short gain inside the 30-yard line. About the 28, four-yard pickup. So Grimmel finishes the day 9 of 21 for 163 yards, four touchdowns and one interception. Yoon has tossed four passes, completed three for 42 yards. He's back to pass again. Looks long over the middle. Has a receiver. Pass is caught inside the five to short of the end zone. With the grab, it was Mario Lomax of Pike High School in Indianapolis. We'll try that again. That was Trayton Shock. 82, not 32. In any case, it's first down and goal from the 2-yard line. Yoon up under center. Walsh and Lambert split behind him. Here's a handoff. Walsh testing that left side, and he'll go in standing up. Touchdown, St. Francis. 7:29 left to go in the ball game. That'll make it 48-0 with the extra point attempt yet to come off the foot of Aiden Hostler. Cougars are on a roll right now. They will leave here with four straight victories. They have rolled up a lot of yards. Matter of fact, 478 yards of total offense right now for St. Francis. Snap is down, kick is away, it is through the uprights, and it is good. St. Francis 49, Lawrence Tech nothing, 7:29 to go in the ball game. This is Cougar Football on WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM.
Off for the Cougars, 38, Aiden Hostler. Leads the Blue Devils, 21 Tyler Garrett.
yard touchdown run by Ryan Walsh and the extra point by Hostler gives St. Francis a 49-0 lead over Lawrence Tech. We have 7:29 left to go in this one. Hostler with the ball teed up at the 35-yard line. The approach and the kick end over end down the middle of the field. Grabbed at about the 3-yard line, 5, 10-yard line, 15 to the 20-yard line. Tyler Garrett, 25-yard line, hops over one tackler and will be knocked down
21, Tyler Garrett
after a good return, all things considered. And the Lawrence Tech offense will come out again. It has been a rough day for the Blue Devils.
By 12, Adam Smith.
139 yards of total offense on 58 plays. That's just under 2.5 a crack.
Lawrence Tech will start. First and 10 on their own. 28-yard line.
Looks like Osman remains in at quarterback.
Yes, that is true.
Twin running backs in the backfield. And a handoff and nothing doing that time. Ball carrier was Ben Britton. He was hit and dropped almost immediately.
Ben Britton, the ball carrier.
And he just had nowhere to go. Scott Hudson, who scored a touchdown against Madonna on a 50-yard fumble return. He got the tackle that time. Osman turns. Hands off. Not much there. A couple of yards.
Jacob Ranney, the ball carrier.
Jacob Ranney, his first carry, redshirt sophomore. It'll bring up third down and 11 for the Blue Devils. About 6:20 left to go in this one. Third down and 11. Osman back in the shotgun. Trips to his left. One to the right. Snap comes back. Osman, and down he goes again. Pocket caved in. He is sacked. Was sacked for the sixth time this afternoon. Well, Scott Hudson got the sack that time.
Scott Hudson, 96. Wallace Canad.
We'll change it to Wallace Kanash, the freshman out of South Bend, Indiana, Penn High School. Freshman, 6'2", 255. On comes Carter Dixon to punt it away, standing at his own 5. Snap comes back. Here's the rush. Kick is away. Kick was at least altered. And will spin like a top at the 35-yard line. So the Cougars take over first down and 10. Change of possession. 5:21 to go in this one. 49-0. St. Francis leading Lawrence Tech. Lawrence Tech at Siena Heights next Saturday. St. Francis at Marion. 1:05 kickoff here on WGL. Will come back out at quarterback. Ryan Walsh, one of the backs behind him. Relatively tight formation. He spent most of the half in the old wing T look. Here is a handoff and an end around and a big, big hit. The ball carrier that time on the play. He paid the price, Kate Chandler, and he was hit and literally bounced to the turf that time. It'll bring up second down and 12, 2-yard loss. Yoon up under center. Motion, Yoon back to pass. Looks long down the right, as a receiver out there, and the grab is made inside the 5 at about the 3-yard line. That's Colin McPeak, the redshirt freshman out of Fishers High School in Noblesville. 32-yard diving reception. Make it 31 as they put it back at the 4-yard line. first down and goal for the Cougars. There's a handoff to the right side. Lambert spun down short of the end zone at about the 2 yard line. Maybe the one. It'll be a 3 yard gain. Second and goal from the one. Clock moving. 3:45 and counting. 49 to nothing. The Cougars 1 yard away from adding to that. Lambert and Walsh split behind Yoon. Yoon looks back to the sideline. Back up under center. Motion. Handoff. Jet sweep. And this is not going to be a touchdown.
I think they've done a lot. I think they've
done a lot. McKee Chandler on the carry.
Now the play went wide. And a loss of a half yard or so on the play. So it'll be third down and goal from about the 2 yard line. And Chandler on that last carry. Here's Lambert to the right side, tries to cut it back, and he'll be stopped at the 1 yard line, maybe just inside it. Fourth and goal from just inside the 1 yard line with about 2:50 left to go in the ball game. Fourth down and goal, play clock down to 20 seconds. And the Cougars are up to the line of scrimmage, backfield is split. Here is a handoff, Lambert, right side, gets that push and gets the touchdown. Hassan Lambert from Northside High School, he makes it a 55 to nothing game with the extra point attempt yet to come by Aiden Hostler. It has been all St. Francis Cougars here this afternoon. Easily their biggest win of the season. Oh, it's going to be Derek Robb. He is the backup kicker. He's starting a punter. He will attempt the extra point. Snap is down, kick is away. It is through the uprights. It is good by Derek Robb. 2:22 left to go in this one. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech 56 to nothing. We'll come back after this. This is Cougar Football on WGL News Radio 1250 AM at 105.5 FM. Football is live. Tyler Garrett has to bring it out of the end zone. He touched it before he went in, and he's going to be dropped inside the 5 yard line. Son Lambert scoring on a 1 yard touchdown run. Derek Robb with the extra point. 56 to nothing. St. Francis leads Lawrence Tech. We have 2:13 left to go in the game. We also have a penalty flag down on the field. Flag down, let's get the call.
During the return, holding, return team, number 17.
half the distance, end of the run. Perfect.
Well, half the distance will put the ball back at the 1 yard line because it's sitting squarely at the 2 right now. Coming into the ball game. First of all, they have a shotgun backfield about as deep as you can get in the backfield. Long pass down the right side, and it is caught by Garrett, and this could be trouble. This is going to go for a 99-yard touchdown to Tyler Garrett. Tyler Garrett caught it at about, we'll say, between the 25 and 30, and then there was no one left at home. He turns it into a 99-yard touchdown. Well, that's quite a way to crack the scoreboard. Alex Osman with the toss. The ball was actually caught at about the 34-yard line, and then Garrett was off to the races. The extra point attempt coming by Vincent Robinson. Had a field goal earlier that was blocked. Snap is down, kick is away, it's good, 56-7.
Robinson's extra point attempt is good, making the score. Your University of St. Francis Cougars 56.
So 56-7. 1:57 left to go. We'll keep things right here for now. A reminder, we will wrap things up in the post-game show. We will recap the scoring, and there's a lot to go down, plus the numbers as well. But Lawrence Tech's numbers just got a boost with a 99-yard touchdown pass. We've got about equaled, or came close to equaling, much of the yardage in the ballgame. In fact, that'll take Lawrence Tech over 225 yards passing, 229 total, but 99 of it on one play. Meanwhile, St. Francis has put up 513 yards in the game. We'll have a chance to add to it here. Kick is away, high, end over end. This is not going to make it to the end zone. It'll be picked up. A big return and a big hit. David Smith, he was popped out of the turf at about the 12-yard line. 1:53 left to go in this one. 56-7. Cougars can just about run out the clock here. I say just about, it'll be close. But Bodie Dickerson is out at quarterback now. Dickerson turns, hands off, 3 yards to the 15. That's Ryan Walsh, who scored earlier.
Ryan Walsh, ball carrier.
So Bodie Dickerson, the third quarterback in the ballgame now. A lot of younger faces. We saw Malachi Jackson earlier in the ballgame. Cam Gillentine as well. Snap comes back to Dickerson. He will look and throw to the near side. And the reception is made. Tequan Taylor, the receiver.
Personal foul. Face pass.
Face pass. 15 yards. That's going to be a first down. A couple of penalty flags were down on the near side in front of us, but shielded by the officials on the bench. Well, that really should do it then. That's the first down. A couple of snaps and this game will be history. All St. Francis this afternoon as they will improve to 4-2 on the season. Hand off. Walsh is going to be gang tackled. There's not a whole lot there. Carson Clark is in at quarterback now. So he's the fourth quarterback of the day for the Cougars. This could be the final play of the game. Could be. We'll see. Clark back in the shotgun. He's back to pass. Looks long down the left, and there is all sorts of contact, and no penalty flag, incomplete. Looks like Bodie Dickerson was the intended receiver there. So not the final play of the game. Matter of fact, they'll have to run two more to get this one over with. 31 seconds showing on the game clock, 21 on the play clock. Carson Clark in at quarterback. Twin receivers to his right. Motion coming from the left. There's a flip to Dickerson, sweeping right. 40, 45, and he'll go out of bounds. He's got the first down.
Number three, Bodie Dickerson on the carry.
So Dickerson able to pick up a first down there on the old toss. Move the sticks. And now this could be the final play of the game. Carson Clark takes the snap, hands it off. Ryan Walsh, look out. He's to the 40-yard line, to the 35, to the 30, and he'll be knocked down. It looks like inbounds. They'll say he's inbounds. He picked up on the play. Big yardage. And that clock is rolling down to 12 seconds, and that should be the ball game.
1 minute left.
The St. Francis Cougars make it four straight wins this afternoon, and they do it in impressive fashion as they defeat Lawrence Tech 56-7. The Cougars now 4-2 on the season. Lawrence Tech drops to 1-6. 56-7, our final score here this afternoon. We'll come back and wrap it up on the postgame show after this timeout on your home for Cougar football, WGL News Radio 1250 AM and 105.5 FM.
Fans, don't forget the USF men's soccer team will be home tonight against Dozier College at 7 p.m. Come back and finish the homecoming festivities with a Cougar soccer match. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Cougar Athletic Department, we would like to